You are listening to the Hiking Radio Network, where we talk the walk with shows by hikers about hikers for everybody.
Welcome to the Trail Dames Podcast, where we speak with women who love to dance upon this earth. Hey everyone, welcome to the Trail Dames Podcast. We're so glad you're here. Today we're going to share with you one of our collection of stories from the trail, so sit back and join us as one of our favorite dames shares with you her story of hiking and dancing on the trail. My name is Anna Huthmaker. My friends all call me Mudbutt, and you are listening to the Trail Dames Podcast. I'm gonna dance upon this earth. Hey everyone, this is Anna, and today on the Trail Dames Story, I'm sharing with you my friend Margaret Webster's story. She wrote this about this amazing place in upstate New York, and she gave me permission to share it with you guys. So I hope you all enjoy the wonder of Watkins Glen. Did you ever see some promotional materials for a place or a thing, and you think, wow, that's really something. I need to put that on my must-see list. You carve out time in your calendar, you make plans, figure out the best route to take to get there, and you check the weather for days ahead of the event. As the date approaches, you can barely maintain your enthusiasm that you are going to see this amazing thing that you saw on the promotional materials. The fated day comes, and you get up, shower, and put on just the right outfit specifically picked out and laid out the night before for this event. You pack a lunch and snacks, careful to select just the right food for the activity of the day. You have dutifully gassed up the car the night before, so you don't waste the 15 minutes of the next day, so you can get to this amazing place faster. You get in the car all excited, and you drive several hours to your destination. And sometimes the reality doesn't match the advertisement. You get there, and you get out of the car, and you look around. It looks like something akin to a ghost town, but not nearly as cool. Nothing looks like the promotional material you saw. You wander in vain looking for the same things as in the pictures, and slowly you come to the realization that you were duped and that this particular thing totally sucked ass. Not just regular ass, but big, sticky ass. You leave shell-shocked, sad, dejected, and frustrated that you wasted time for this. And as you drive away, you get a little angry. But then sometimes it actually does. It does match up to all that promotional material. Well, I remember seeing the promotional material on Facebook for Watkins Glen State Park in upstate New York, and I was struck dumb by the images of all these waterfalls and beautiful old stone bridges carved into the rock. The images conjured up this wonderfully romantic fairy tale place. I exclaimed breathless, oh my God, I just have to go to that place. It looks amazing. So I got ready for the trip. I put it on my calendar. I planned it for a weekend trip, as this was a little over a 3-hour drive. In the preceding days, I went through my personal trip readiness process. And when the day finally arrived, I was excited. I made the actually 5-ish-hour trip up there from central Connecticut just to see how it was. Due to the fact that I had been duped in the past, there were some nagging thoughts of, what if it sucks? It'll end up being a big waste of time and energy. In the end, though, I figured that the worst-case scenario, I would do what I always do. I would find someone to talk to, and as always, they'll be amazing, it would make my day, and probably result in an awesome People from the Road blog entry. So here I was, finally arriving at Watkins Glen. I get there, and my GPS takes me to this large parking lot, and I gotta say, it was fairly packed. They also had people monitoring the parking lot, helping with the process. I saw this as a good sign. It means it's a popular place, right? What I initially saw was a couple of playscapes for children and picnic tables. I get nervous because I do not see or hear any waterfalls. I continue to walk, and I notice that there's a public pool and a conference center, as well as maintained pavilions, but still no waterfalls. I stop to take a little bio break, and then I keep searching. I see this little sign indicating that I was on the right track, though, to the Gorge Trail. So I start walking down this trail. It's called the Gorge Trail, and it's switchbacks. Down, down, down. And all I kept thinking was, crap, this better be good, because if it sucks and I have to schlep back up that hill, I am going to be pissed. A few times I thought about turning around and just forgetting all about it. Then I see a red-faced woman gasping for air coming in the opposite direction. So I stopped her and I asked, is it worth the walk back up the trail? She took a deep breath to speak and emphatically said, oh yeah. So I kept going. And boy, was I ever glad I did. Now I could hear the water, and it sounded like a big grand waterfall. And then it came into view, and wow, just wow. I have to tell you, the view exceeded all that promotional material. It exceeded all my expectations. And it wasn't what I actually saw on the Facebook page. It was much more, so much more. I couldn't believe how wonderful it was. And that was just the first view of many more beautiful views along the walk to the end of the Gorge Trail. So I have to tell you, if you get the opportunity to go to upstate New York, I highly recommend going to this place. The websites don't even give you an inkling what the state park is all about. As I mentioned, they have everything you could imagine to have for a family to enjoy the day out. And they have campsites and all that. But the Gorge Walk, this is the crown jewel of the park for sure. Watkins Glen Gorge Walk features 19 waterfalls. 19! It has numerous cascades, it has carved out tunnels and stone bridges. It's all to make the 2-mile walk really magical, and it goes by very quickly. When you do go, there's a couple of things I do want you to know. Be aware, the trail and the walkway, it gets really wet in places. So wear some good shoes. Much of it's wet and slippery. There are lots of carved out stairs from the waterfalls as well. It can be slippery in these spots too, so just take your time and enjoy. After you walk the Gorge Trail, there's a series of stairs to get to the top. There's a cute little snack shop, and it sells ice cream and beer and a covered pavilion area and picnic tables. Perfect place to hang out after your hike. So bring some cash for each person. I discovered they also provide a shuttle that'll take you back to your car, which is great, but the shuttle is not free and it requires cash. So make sure you have some on you just in case you want to take the shuttle back. In my case, I had no idea there was a shuttle, and I would have loved to have taken it back, I won't lie to you. But unfortunately, I did not have any money on me. So next time, instead, I returned by a different path. I ended up taking this different hiking trail back to the car that ran parallel to the Gorge Trail. It was a really lovely walk through the woods, and there were hardly any people or hills on this trail. It was a really pleasant walk, and in the end, I was happy to get some extra time just in the woods. If you're a photography buff, Watkins Glen will be a really exciting place to come take pictures, but it will also be frustrating because due to popularity, there's a lot of people. It also would be double tough to try and get a shot without people in it, just be prepared. So I want to just say in conclusion, the marketing materials, although great, they didn't do this place justice. I highly recommend it because it was better than everything they put out there. Take a trip to Watkins Glen State Park. See it for yourself. I promise it won't disappoint. I'm Anna, and I'm actually reading from Margaret Webster, and that is her Trail Dame story. Now, before we go, I have to tell you. So when she shared this with me and I looked at it, she's got pictures with the story. And oh, my God, she is so right. This place looks incredible. I live in Georgia, and I think I may actually have to go to upstate New York just to see it. So I'm going to put some of those pictures in the show notes. along with links to the state park so you know how to find it. Also, I'm linking to Margaret Webster's blog, which you should definitely check out if you've never seen it. It's called Lessons from the Road, USA. She's got a blog. She's written a book, and her writing is really wonderful, so go check her out. I hope everyone enjoyed it. Now, while you're listening to podcasts, don't forget to go to our new website, thehikingradionetwork.com, and listen to all the other podcasts that are on there. I promise you'll love them and you'll be inspired and motivated to get out and hike. I'm Anna. All my friends call me Mudbutt. And you have been listening to the Trail Dames podcast. I'm gonna dance upon this earth. Thank you so much for joining us for a Trail Dames story. If that's the kind of thing you enjoy, then make sure you go and subscribe to the Trail Dames podcast. You can find us anywhere that podcasts are gathered. And if you have any stories of your own you'd like to share, give us a call at info@traildames.com. We'd love to have you join us and share your story. My name is Anna Huffmaker. My friends all call me Mudbutt. And thank you for joining us on the Trail Dames podcast. I'm gonna dance upon this earth. And I'm gonna find joy in all this madness. I have always been a dreamer since I was.
Madness, and I'm gonna be the one that you see today.